Good evening. For 50 years, Olivia Newton-John dazzled us with her music and her natural warmth and charm. For 30 years, she was also dealing with breast cancer. Her death at the age of 73 has brought great sadness to her family, friends and fans around the world, while also reminding us of the great moments in her career, those songs so many of us will have been singing and humming today.
She only needed one name, Olivia. The bright smile, those sparkling eyes and the voice. Olivia Newton-John caught the eye of the world when, as a 29-year-old, she slipped into 1950s Rydell High as Sandy from Australia in the 1978 mega-hit musical Grease.
Sandy!
Danny!
She was the goody-goody, and along with cool cat Danny Zuko, John Travolta, the world fell in love and a star was born.
In close-ups, you could sort of feel how warm and friendly she was. I mean, it came across. She had star power, and it came right across to the audience.
Sandy,
tell me about it. Stir.
The black pants, the big hair. Women wanted to be her, and men wanted to be with her. As for those tights, she kept them and they still fit.
About a year ago, I was kind of dared into trying them on.
And
I got them on, amazingly.
Grease proved to be an enduring party playlist for generations. Wow, 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 wow. A soundtrack of classics, and Hollywood wanted more Olivia. In 1980, it was Xanadu. Xanadu, Xanadu. And in 1981, the good girl gave us Physical. Olivia Newton-John was born in the UK. Her family migrated to Australia when she was six. At 14, she joined an all-girl group with three friends.
I used to sing for fun in a coffee lounge. I was still at school, but on Fridays and Saturdays I used to go in there and sing along. And somebody came in and heard me sing and said, why don't you go in for this talent contest that was on television?
Schoolgirl, she did, winning talent show Sing Sing Sing, a slingshot into a lifelong career.
See the sun in the sky, always riding high at Christmas time.
In the 1970s, she broke into the country scene in the United States.
Down by the banks of the Ohio,
she covered John Denver.
Country road.
Bewitched Dean Martin.
Cause just a little loving will go a long way.
Performed alongside ABBA.
Thank you for the music, the songs I'm singing.
And starred at Eurovision. But pop would make her a superstar. Partnership born on set, transformed into a lifelong friendship. Today, from John Travolta, my dearest Olivia, you made all of our lives so much better. Your impact was incredible. I love you so much. We will see you down the road and we will all be together again. Yours from the moment I saw you and forever, your Danny. You're John. And from another T-Bird.
She was very, very much
one of those people who was, in fact, that light of the love and the light that I'm talking about. She glowed everywhere she went and with everything she did.
Along with the highs, there were the lows. In 1984, Olivia married her longtime boyfriend, actor Matt Lattanzi. They had daughter Chloe, but divorced a decade later. She was by Chloe's side as she battled an eating disorder. And mystery surrounded what happened to her partner, Patrick McDermott, who went missing during a fishing trip off California in 2005. It's been long rumoured he faked his own death and is living in Mexico.
The pain will always be there. I'll always miss him. I love him. I miss him. But, you know, I can't do anything about it. We don't know what happened, and I don't know if I ever will know what happened.
In 2008, a new marriage to businessman John Easterling, her partner in life and a life in charity. Today, from her daughter Chloe, a tribute of family photos of a life where our Olivia was just mum, celebrating her mother's career. Which, like the rest of us, came with some embarrassing mum moments. And last year, a duet.
Looking for a window in the world.
When Sydney hosted the Olympics, it was our Olivia in a reunion with longtime friend John Farnham, who welcomed the athletes to the Games. They would perform together for decades, one of the final times in 2020, raising money for bushfire victims. Today, from her close friend John Farnham, behind the iconic smile was a tenacious fighter, a beautiful voice and a loyal friend. And as Australia woke up to the news, there was no hiding the pain.
Your relationship with her was so beautiful. No, that's all right. It's all right. It's the depth of
there
feeling.
There aren't too many people that you can do a Zoom.
We can feel it.
Zoom thing.
Yeah.
From Delta Goodrum, who played Olivia in a 2018 miniseries, the whole world will feel this heartbreak today because the entire world felt Olivia's unmatched light, a force for good, a force of nature, strong and kind. And from Kylie, a precious memory lined up with her childhood idol to meet Princess Diana. She was and always will be an inspiration to me in so many ways. A life of music, but sadly, the other constant in Olivia Newton-John's life for the last 30 years has been breast cancer, telling Oprah in 1992 she'd beat it.
I don't like the word remission. I like to say it's gone, it's over, it's out of my life, and that's the way I think.
But in 2017, cancer returned for a third time. It left her in excruciating pain. It spread to her bones, and last night, Olivia lost the fight at age 73. Olivia Newton-John picked up 4 Grammys and sold more than 100 million records. But she leaves behind so much more. Generations of fans who adored her, none more so than in the heart of Hollywood, Olivia Newton-John's star on the Walk of Fame.
She meant everything to me. She was my inspiration. My favourite actress, my favourite singer, everything, just to pursue my dreams in acting. And now that I found a way that she passed away, it just breaks my heart.
She's just such a huge part of all of our lives in Australia. She was a wonderful, compassionate, beautiful human being. And I hope she's at peace, finally, and she's left an incredible, incredible mark. It's really sad.
Among the mourners, the casting director of Grease.
How are you feeling, Joel?
Well, I'm doing the best I can to not do this. No. She was incredible. She was just as lovely on the inside as she was on the outside.
Letting us in on a secret very few people knew.
She initially was not interested in Grease. She had been embarrassed by a movie she had made earlier before she became a huge star here. She asked for a screen test. so that she could see herself and John and decide whether she wanted to do the movie or not.
Olivia Newton-John died at her ranch in Santa Barbara, California, as she entered her last battle with cancer. In one of her final interviews, she revealed the words she lived by.
This too will pass. Life is never the same. We're moving and changing all the time. You just got to go with the flow. If you can, don't resist, because it'll take you down with you.
The summer night.
Olivia, the music, the films, what a ride it was for all of us. Lizzie Pearl, Nine News.
Well, Olivia Newton-John's death will leave a gap in the world of show business, but her work supporting cancer research will carry on for a long time. It's also a tribute to the great fighting spirit that lay behind the smile.
Singer, songwriter, actress and activist. Olivia Newton-John's cause was cancer.
Thank you so much.
She gave people hope. She gave people an understanding that they could look to the future and have hope.
Her own diagnosis nearly 30 years ago was met with courage, determination and endless optimism.
You've had so many battles, Olivia. How are you not broken?
Oh, goodness.
Come on.
I've had and am having an amazing life.
From one interview in 2017 to another 2 years later in 2019, Olivia was never the victim, always the survivor.
I'm so lucky that I've been through this three times and I'm still here. I'm living with it.
But the tabloids in America had all but written her off.
The National Enquirer's front page story claims the end is near.
To read that you're dead is, or you're dying, is a very strange experience.
The rumours of my death have been greatly exaggerated.
In fact, it was her will to live and to help others to do the same that became her purpose. A wellness and research clinic in Melbourne was founded in her name.
It's a culmination of many years and many dreams. And I'm proud, I'm humbled, I'm so grateful.
And today, flowers and tributes to the love and light of the clinic.
She absolutely loved that she was a part of bringing this to a reality. It was her dream.
That dream to incorporate a wellness, whether it be music, yoga or meditation, to the treatment of cancer.
Olivia Newton-John, just an amazing person. Just her positivity.
Julie Bailey is a breast cancer survivor. Her daughter Rachel, who was 19 weeks pregnant when she too was diagnosed and checked into the wellness centre.
Your eyes light up because you drop her off and you see her name up there and I think, oh, she's in good hands. For her to have created that for us in Melbourne is amazing.
In October, it will be 10 years since the centre opened its doors. They will celebrate with the annual walk, but the starter will be missing. Olivia Newton-John refused to be intimidated by cancer or let it rule her life.
I let it go and tell it to leave and talk to my body to heal itself and don't try to make it that.
In her last photo she shared with the world, it was an Olivia at peace. But despite all her magic, the ending we all wanted was not to be. Damien Ryan, Nine News.
Our US correspondent, Alison Petrowski, has spent the day speaking with fans in Hollywood. She joins me now live from Los Angeles. Ali, what's the feeling been there?
Well, Pete, I've seen thousands of people come to her star today. Many Americans hearing our accents and coming up to us saying, we are so sorry for your country's loss. Many Australians here in Los Angeles hearing the news and coming down here feeling compelled to pay tribute to the great star. No words at the moment, Pete, on the funeral here in California. The family simply asking to respect their privacy at the time. They also say instead of flowers, people should consider donating to Olivia's foundation fund. She was a remarkable woman, Pete, one of our country's greatest exports, loved at home and also here in Hollywood.